Bob Leary. Tommy said he didn't do Dixieland, but yes, he loves him. Patricia said the same thing. We don't believe what you say now. Jonathan, have you been doing anything since we last saw you here?
Yes, I have. What about Tommy?
Well, we had a review of the New York Times yesterday. What's that?
Yeah, I'm currently in an off-Broadway show called One Night with Fanny Brice, and it's getting great reviews, though.
They let you down in Florida, huh?
They did, yes.
Yeah, that was nice of them to do that. Anything else? Could I just give you some buzzwords and you weave it in any way you want?
Yes.
I'll say Danny Pearl. I'll say kind of ambassadorial work that you've been doing. Any composition you've been writing? Any violins that they might have shared in your whole board?
Sure, that seems like more than enough. There will be attempts afterwards, so I will be expecting all of you to be taking notes of this. So a few years ago, a journalist by the name of Daniel Pearl was captured and murdered by terrorists. And what most people do not know about him was that he had this goal of achieving world peace through music. And he was actually a violinist. Wherever he went, he would always take his violin and try to promote world peace. So this one violin maker by the name of John Cooper was so touched by Danny's message of world peace through music that he decided to create a violin in memory of Daniel Pearl. And he gave it to Mark O'Connor, and Mark said that he wanted each student that has a chance to get a chance, like he would choose one student a year to play the violin, and 2 years ago I was honored to be the recipient of the Daniel Pearl Violin. Please hold the applause until the speech is finished.
Have you noticed this little guy's voice has changed?
So I decided to write a song for Danny Pearl since I had recently taken up composing. So without further ado, here is Danny's Groove. Don't you amp on that.
See, and Tommy have been practicing this for... Actually, they haven't practiced it at all. This is a first.
Thank you.
Bill Wallet introduces for a new tune, now another very modern tune called Basin Street Blues. John, you try to stay out of the way on this, all right?
Thank you.
Anybody out there from Michigan?
Yeah.
This is Wolverine Blues. It has nothing to do with Michigan. request for from 2 years ago. We hope that John has approved his production on it right now. It's called Nuage. Thank you. hope that you get to do fours and everybody please don't fall. Jonathan was here 2 years ago, and we're asking him to do an encore performance with John Lamb of Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho.
namely Jasmine Williams. Speaking of Bitch Fighter Man, did you know this guy was selected to be Bitch Fighter Man on Broadway? That's the good news. The bad news is,
they fired me right away.
We just never had it, but we had some pretty some wonderful stories about the audition later on.
Thank you.
choice, as long as you get it right, sir.
Thank you.
caused to be produced and which he arranged for Louis Armstrong called Wonderful World. He asked me beforehand, he said, what key do you do this in? You want to do an F, right?
Yeah.
F it is. But you said the tempo. Thank you. Patricia King. Come here.